Well, it's one thing writing this in front of a computer. It's another thing sitting in front of Josh Shannon. Dear Josh Shannon, oh boy, how do I begin to thank you? You have meant so much to us. We love you and your family. We love your preaching, your honesty, openness, and your sensitivity to the Spirit, your passion to exalt Jesus, and your love for us. I'm sure everyone's felt that. Your genuine interest in each of us, and your listening ear. And we love your willingness to follow him now. Excuse me. Even though we're going to miss you so much. Thank you for leading us to pray on Wednesday nights as a church. We believe that it was very significant that you started the prayer meetings just before our church hit so many tough times. And we will, Frank and I wrote this together, we will always remember that one evening when the love of Jesus was with us in such a very, very tangible way down there in the pastor's room downstairs. And you were praying face down on the ground. And your prayer was, Lord, do whatever it takes to make us a people who love like you do. God heard your prayer, and he is answering it. And even this is a part of that answering, along with all the troubles that we went through. We also had some humor in those times, and we remember your gentle correction when one of us, we won't say who, was bowing low in prayer down in that same room, inadvertently exposed some rump. And Shannon, though you have not been on the skyline, you are every bit as responsible for all the blessings that we've received. Thank you so much. And Emma, God bless you in your art. I have lovely memories of painting with you, and I know you're going to go far in that. Philemon 7, verse 7, says it for us when it says, your love has given me great joy and encouragement because you, brother, have refreshed the hearts of the Lord's people. And our prayer is that you, as you and your family leave, you will come into an exciting season of refreshment as you walk in obedience and humility, love, and surrender. God bless you.